it's Thomas here, and today we're doing a quick review on the BRS Extra Thick Super Glue Gel and Instaset Accelerator. If you want a safe and easy glue to work with for gluing down frags, bonding your aquascape, or your DIY reefing projects that's not gonna break the bank and is backed by the BRS name, then check out our BRS Extra Thick Super Glue Gel. I'm also gonna show you how Instaset is a game changer for super glue. I wish I knew about it sooner. Cyanoacrylate or super glue gel cures relatively fast, creates a fantastic bond with just about any material, including fleshy coral, and is completely non-toxic and reef safe, which is why it's become the go-to adhesive for gluing coral frags to plugs or rock rubble, mounting those corals to the rockwork in your reef tank underwater, for bonding rocks in your aquascape so they don't easily come apart, and even for simple DIY projects or quick fixes on equipment around the tank. The team at BRS has done what they do best and brought a great value to a simple and effective product so that you can spend less to get exactly what you need. This definitely rings true with the BRS Extra Thick Super Glue Gel. And just like any BRS product, if there's anything you need, we're always here to help. The Extra Thick Gel is really easy to work with. The consistency makes controlling the flow out of the bottle precise. It doesn't dribble or run off of surfaces and can be built up nicely to create a dollop of glue to push a frag into, while also being viscous enough to flow into cracks and crevices of rockwork for scaping. If you don't use the glue often, the components inside can separate a little bit, leaving a thinner liquid at the top and the thicker stuff at the bottom, but just give it a really good shake. Or knead the tube a few times and it'll easily mix back to being extra thick and ready to go. You can get the Extra Thick Gel in three different sizes and each one has advantages. The 20 gram tube is really easy to get into small spaces and is also the best option for applying glue underwater because it doesn't suck water back into itself after squeezing out some glue like the plastic bottles can. The 1 ounce bottle is my go-to for the average hobbyist looking to have some glue on hand for fragging and general use, as well as gluing rocks together while aquascaping outside of the water. While it's not as small as the 20 gram tube, it's still easy to maneuver and get in between the contact points of the rock. It's what I personally use, and at almost 30 grams and the same price as the 20 gram tube, it's a really good value. The 10 ounce bottle is a Goliath and is a huge value at 40% less cost per ounce than the 1 ounce bottle. And while not practical for use underwater and not nearly as easy to sneak into tight spaces, it is the best option for reefers looking to do some bulk fragging or other applications where you want the most glue per dollar possible. It also comes with two application tips, so if you clog one up and can't clean it anymore, you still have another one on hand so you can use all of that glorious glue. Then once you add the BRS ReefSafe Instaset into the mix, you have what I now consider to be the ultimate combo. Spritz Instaset onto freshly applied super glue gel, and it will cause the exterior layer to immediately set firm. This is a lifesaver when it comes to gluing down lopsided or precarious coral frags, like branching SPS. Instead of having to hold the frag to the plug and wait a few minutes for it to set enough to be able to let it go, you can spritz the frag plug with Instaset, put a dab of super glue gel on the base of the coral, press them together, and it'll stay put. It does create some excess heat though, so you will want to have a container of salt water to immediately put the frag in when you're done to keep it cool. It also works incredibly well to get a quick bond while you're scaping your rock work, making the whole process a lot easier and faster. Not having to wait several minutes before moving on to the next rock really helps with the creative flow. Bear in mind, with thicker globs of glue, it's only going to be the outer layer that sets, so it will take a few hours for the entirety of that glue to finish curing. So once you're done, give your scape a few hours before trying to move it, or better, build it inside the tank so you don't need to move it after. Speaking of scaping, the BRS Extra Thick Gel and Instaset changed the way I look at aquascaping. Let me explain how. Previously, I've used two-part epoxy and thermal beads to bond my rocks, but on the tank you see behind me, I really wanted to use mortar to create a very sturdy permanent scape with bonds that were much easier to hide and will be more inviting for coralline growth. The challenge with mortar, though, is that it isn't sticky, so it's not gonna hold the rockwork together while it cures, but once it's cured, it is basically indestructible. To make the process much easier, I used the BRS Extra Thick Super Glue Gel and Instaset to create my scape and hold it together. If I didn't like the bond I made, even after the Instaset, I could still pull the rocks apart to adjust it, which is something I couldn't do if I let it solidify with mortar. And then once my scape was exactly what I wanted, I went in with the mortar and reinforced all of the joints to create that ultra secure bond that essentially turned my scape into a single piece of rock. I can confidently say after doing this, I am not gonna go back to my previous methods of bonding rock work. This is how I'm gonna do it. Now with that said, I do really like the idea of using a gun to apply glue, especially if I'm gonna sit down to do a bunch of bulk fragging. Sounds pretty ergonomic. Or maybe just using tiny little tubes if I need to get into the tiniest little nook or cranny. If you wanna see more glue options, the best of 2019 perhaps, Ryan and Randy have it all laid up for you right here. These are on it too. Check it out. Lots of glue options, more than I realized. Also, did you know that Instaset smells like strawberries? It smells like strawberries. I didn't know until I used it the first time. That was a cool surprise.